Hello, I will be analyzing the short film The Low Road, which was created in 2014 by Nate Daniel. A brief summary of the film would be that road in a truck when he sees what appears to be a dead body in the road, which is referred to as the gentleman in the road. Upon closer inspection, that dead body is very much not dead, and they kind of battle it out, and the gentleman in the road actually ends up stealing the man with the cool hat's truck. And so that convinces the man with the cool hat that he should also do the same thing to the next car that goes by. Though the film is only 3 minutes and 30 seconds long, it utilizes cinematic language in an effective manner. So, first I'm going to talk about points of view. There are kind of 3 main points of view in this. The majority of it is filmed through the point of view of the man with the cool hat, as he's the protagonist, kind of knows what's, kind of sees what's going on, that kind of thing. Briefly, during the fight scene, it does switch to the gentleman in the road's point of view, just as they're trading blows, and then again, briefly it switches to the lady driving the second car, that is the lady with an even cooler hat. There's no narrative in this at all, just kind of a brief use of words by the man with the cool hat, kind of like an, oh, huh, dead body, like, let's go investigate type thing. Just kind of some grunting there too, which does break pattern. I mean, you'd assume that if one saw a dead body in the road, they'd immediately call the authorities and not be like, oh, huh, I think I should go investigate that, which is kind of what sets it up in the first place. Besides that, there's just some nature sounds, because it takes place in a kind of secluded forest, like along a road, and there's, music in the beginning, orchestral music, which is kind of, which is assumed to be kind of only, like, only the viewers can hear it at first, but then it does actually reveal that it's, in the radio of the man's truck. Lighting, it seems pretty bright, because, the sunlight's filtering through the trees, but also the dead body is in shade, so it's a little bit darker there. As for time, it takes place over a span of what seems like just a few minutes, so that's kind of interesting. Going back to the whole no narration thing, there's definitely a vibe of being, of the audience being right there, kind of alongside the characters, instead of just watching it from a screen, as what generally happens with movies. The characters are all surround characters, lifelike, obviously, they're humans, there's not really anything weird about that. As for obstacles in the film that the protagonist, the man with the cool hat, faces, there's quite literally an obstacle in the road for him, that being, excuse me, the gentleman in the road, aka the presumably dead body. The suspense and surprise, they kind of trade back and forth off in the short film. There's, obviously suspense, with the whole death, seeing the body thing, more suspense in the, fight scene, and then, again, there's more kind of, surprise when the corpse comes alive and steals the truck. Scope and setting's pretty simple. It's, set in the forest, kind of around present day. As for filming, kind of camera angles and aspects of filming, that kind of thing, it's, the lens is a middle focal length lens, which is normal, so again, that kind of adds to the whole audience being there. It's generally filmed from a medium shot, and then it changes to a medium close-up, so we see a shot of the scene kind of wider back, and then changes, again, to the point of view of the character's face. It's filmed eye level, again, adding to that realistic thing. There's also no special effects, except for perhaps some makeup around the man with the cool hat's eye after he gets punched by the gentleman in the road. In terms of spatial relationships, the fight scene has a closer spatial relationship, and, it's a bit more chaotic, whereas the rest of the, you know, zooms out, get, like, a closer look, or, a farther look at kind of the whole scene as it is. Continuity editing, it's just shot and reverse shot, so it's between one character, then switches to another, and then back and forth, like that. And so, in conclusion, though this film is short, it utilizes a ton of different aspects, and it's pretty super cool.